The planned merger between State Lenders Land Bank and the Development Bank of the Philippines now officially scrapped. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto made that confirmation Tuesday. Recto also allayed fears the merger would impact the two banks' ability to meet the BSP's minimum capital requirement after their mandated contribution to the Maharlika Investment Fund. The merger was expected to have an estimated asset size of over 4 trillion pesos and a deposit base of 3.5 trillion pesos. It would have become the biggest bank in the country in terms of assets.
I think we're better off with two government depository banks and two members in the Maharlika board. I think we need two government depository banks. Their mandates are totally different. So I think we're better off with two of them.
In local corporate news, Integrated Microelectronics CEO Arthur Tan will step down after his term expires on April 25. Tan, who led IMI for the last 22 years, is credited for expanding the firm's manufacturing services to include Japanese OEMs or original equipment manufacturers. The move helped IMI to become one of the top 25 global EMS players. The company says its board of directors approved a CEO transition plan at a special meeting Tuesday. It identified Lou Hughes, the former COO of NASDAQ-listed EMS firm Universal Electronics, as the potential successor to Tan. Hughes will assume office by May 1st, subject to the board's appointment. Philippine senators dispel fears of an inflationary impact of the proposed legislated 100 peso daily minimum wage hike. That's after the Labor Department warned it could raise employers' costs by about 15 to 25% and set off a chain reaction of increases in transport and commodity costs. Senators argue a salary hike would also mean more purchasing power for Filipinos.
In 2023, the talk about inflation revolves around energy, food prices, and transportation, Mr. President. I don't recall reading anything about inflation due to increase in minimum wage.
Wala po tayo nabalitaan na nagtanggal ng manggagawa ang mga negosyante dahil sa taas sahod noong nakaraang taon. I don't think we see no data to substantiate this fear, Mr. President. Wala po tayong napapalitaan na nagsarang establishment because of the recent increases, Mr. President. Kapag tumataas ang sahod, mariretain empleyado siya sa kumpanya. Ibig sabihin, mas mababa ang turnover rate.
An employers group echoes the Labor Department's warning, adding that any relief from a wage hike will only be temporary. It says smaller firms will bear the brunt of a wage hike and could force them to raise their services costs.
We are just having our inflation going down. And imposing a 100 peso increase will spiral prices. Those who are able to get this 100 pesos will have temporary enjoyment of it, but after a few months, the prices will catch up and it will be lost. While they're still pushing for the 100, when all the economic managers are saying don't do it, all the economists, even the academicians, I have not heard of anybody except those who are proposing it.